discuss. I am Professor Imran Hussain Pirzadeh. Today we discuss about the very important topic or important subject, which is metallurgy. What is meant by metallurgy? As far as we seen, before going to any industries or before going to implement any material to that particular applications, we need to test that particular material from the different aspects. That the metallurgy, that is definition of metallurgy, is what? It is branch of science and technology which deals with the properties of material then its purification process and their production. That is, as far as the definition of metallurgy is concerned, metallurgy is the branch of science and technology which deals with the properties of different types of metals or alloys. Then it's a different purification process from the ores, and finally it's a production. Okay, that is, before going to see the metallurgy, the word metallurgy is come from the two Greek words. First of all, one word is which is metallon, and another word is orgia. The combination of two Greek words, which is metallon and orgia. What is meant by metallon? The meaning of metallon is metal, and meaning of orgia is working. Therefore, the combination of both these words is come into account that the word metallurgy. In short, the metallurgy is the working process of the metals. Okay, that means the word metallon and orgia combines together, the two Greek words combine together, and it will form the metallurgy. Then different types of applications, wide applications are there in the field of aerospace industry, in the field of automotive industries, in the field of military equipments, the manufacturing of military equipments, we are using all there. Next, we are seeing the different types of classification of metallurgy. The metallurgy is classified under three categories. First one, which is extractive metallurgy. Second, which is physical metallurgy. And third one, which is mechanical metallurgy. The metallurgy is classified under three categories, that is extractive metallurgy, physical metallurgy, and finally the mechanical metallurgy. As far as the extractive metallurgy is concerned, the extractive metallurgy is regarding the purification of different types of metals, that is naturally occurring metals, and then refining to that particular metals which are gained from the ores, and we are using as a particular as an application. That is, we are converting that naturally occurring materials into metals and alloys. Then, as far as the physical metallurgy is concerned, the physical metallurgy is regarding to manage the particular material with the requirements of manufacturers. Suppose, at some conditions we require the strength or hardness, we can manage by the alloying of that metal. At some times we must require the material must be ductile or material must be metal, or in somewhere we have to add the different types of carbon percentage. The according to requirements of suppliers or according to requirements of mankind, we can change the properties of metals. And the finally, the mechanical metallurgy. The mechanical metallurgy is regarding the extrusion processes, rolling processes, forging processes, and finally the testing of the material, such as mechanical testing. Which are the different mechanical testings? That is destructive testing, we have seen, which is tensile test, compression test, impact test, hardness test, fatigue test, and creep test. Okay, these are the different types of parts. Then we come to the main point, or one of the main branch from the metallurgy, which is powder metal. As far as we seen, as we know that the casting process, in casting process what we did, we are taking the ingots of metals from the ores, we are refining them and we are sinting inside the furnace, and then after we melting that particular material above its melting point. That means we are rising the temperature of furnace above its melting point, we melting that particular material and sends into a pattern. Okay? And after cooling, we are get the required size and shape of the component. That process, in casting process, we are going for the melting of the metal. But the some materials are there which are very small in size. For example, the particles or the components of our wristwatch. As we know that the hour hand or minute hand is very small. And if we are going for the casting process of that particular hour hand and minute hand, it may be difficult to make a pattern of that particular materials. That's why we are going for the powder metallurgy process. Okay? The next article is that our powder metallurgy process.
Temperature?
recrystallization temperature. What is meant by recrystallization temperature?
Heating that metal below the or half the its melting point.
That is exactly right. In recrystallization temperature, or meaning of recrystallization temperature is what? We are reaching the temperature half of its melting point. Suppose one of the component is having melting point 1000 degree Celsius. We are reaching the temperature above the 500 degree Celsius. What is half of 1000 degree? 500. That means recrystallization temperature is the temperature which is half of its melting point. Okay, this is all. Then the next process is the steps in a powder metallurgy. Okay, write down the steps in powder. The powder metallurgy process is divided under certain steps. First process, which is powder production. Then next one, which is mixing and blending of particular produced powder. Then further, compacting, that is compaction process we have followed by using different types of dyes. Then sintering, the another name of the powder metallurgy process we called as a sintering process. Finally, then sizing to that particular material by setting inside the dye, and last testing of that particular metal. This is the steps in a powder metallurgy process. What is that? First step, which is production of powder. Then that particular produced powder by the different methods we are sending inside our mixer. Then particular mixer is blended with the desired lubricants. Lubricants such as paraffin wax, camphor, or glycerin. Okay. Then compacting at a desired pressure or load according to requirement, and then sintering at a elevated temperature, not above the melting point, that is nearer to the melting point in a controlled atmosphere. Why we are using the controlled atmosphere over there? Because there may be chances that the oxidation of that particular material. That's why we are using controlled atmosphere, and to that atmosphere, or in that atmosphere, we are sending the gas of hydrogen. Okay, that means whenever we are processing or completing the sintering process inside the controlled atmosphere, we are using the vacuum or hydrogen gas. If we are taking that sintering process in uncontrolled atmosphere, there may be chances of that particular material to oxidize, and this is very problematic once after implementing that particular component to the applications. Okay, then sintering, sizing of that particular material, and testing. Okay, I will give a simple example regarding the manufacturing process of a powder metallurgy. Have you seen the concrete manufacturing process? In that, you have taken the cement, sand, stone, and mixing of that particular cement, sand, and stone inside one mixer. Okay? Then we are sending that particular powders. There, cement means in the form of powders. Then sand is in the form of also powder, that is particle size is large but nearer to the powder, and we are adding the stone. Then that particular mixture, the powder, we are sending inside one mixture, and we are continuously running that mixture for a 10-15 minutes with addition of lubricant as a water. Why we are adding the water? The water will help us to mix that particular sand, cement, and stone homogeneously inside that particular mixture, and then we are sending that particular mixture of concrete inside the column. We are pressing that particular column by hand pressing, and then finally we have to get the desired shape of column. That desired shape of column. Okay. Here also same procedure we are going to be manufacture, or we are going to study. We are converting the metals or inputs into a powder. Then that particular powder we are mixing in a different types of pictures such as bicontact picture, double contact picture or oblique contact picture, and then pressing that particular powder inside the at a die. Suppose we want to manufacture a gear, the shape of the die is like a gear. Suppose I want to manufacture a round shape component, the shape of the component must be a round. Okay, these are the, that means according to shape, the whatever the component we may have to require, the shape of the die must lie there. Okay, and then finally sintering and testing process. Okay, then we are come to know the elaborated the production or powder production methods. Okay, chart of powder production methods. Write down. First of all, the classification of powder production. As we know that the powder production is divided under different categories. First process, which is manufacturing of powder, which is mechanical process. Then second one, which is physical process. Third one, which is chemical process. And finally, which is electrochemical process. Then it is our prime duty to manufacture the powders from the different types of inputs. What is meant by inputs? The large particles of metals which are come from the ores. Also, it is our duty to manufacture the pure powder which are implemented for the manufacturing of different mechanical as well as aerospace or military parts. Okay, these are the different applications. And for your kind information, the powders of different types of metals also used as a firework. Firework equipments, that is bullets, we have seen. Inside that also the powder which are manufactured by these processes is used. Okay, then as far as the mechanical process is concerned, the mechanical process is divided into six different categories. First one, which is machining. Second one, which is crushing process. Third one, which is milling process. Fifth one, which is shotting process. Next one, which is draining process. And finally, which is largely used technique, which is atomization process. Then further, the mechanical process is divided under different categories. According to applications, we are using that particular process. Suppose I want to manufacture a very pure powder, or in a mass production, I am going for the atomization process. Suppose I want to manufacture a regular shape components, I will go for the milling process, in which milling the two types are divided under wet milling and dry milling process. Okay, and finally the crushing or milling process. Suppose we have to manufacture the irregular shape components, we are going for the machining or crushing process. Then the physical process is under category of different types. That is first process, which is condensation process. And second one, which is thermal decomposition of metals. That means the condensation and thermal decomposition. And finally, the chemical process are divided under three different categories, which is reduction, then intergranular corrosion, finally, which is precipitation from aqueous solution. I will repeat again. As far as the first step in a powder metallurgy process, which is the powder production method, is divided under four different categories. First one, mechanical process, physical process, chemical process, and finally the electrochemical process. The mechanical process is also under different categories or divided into different types, such as machining, crushing, milling, shorting process, graining process, and finally the atomization process. Okay. Then physical process is divided under different two types, such as condensation process and thermal decomposition process. And the chemical process is also divided under three types, such as reduction of the particular metals by using different types of reducing agent, then intergranular corrosion, and precipitation from an aqueous solution. Okay, these are the different types. Okay, first of all, as far as we seen the milling process, the machining process, first process, which is machining process, in that process we are converting that particular powders into a chips, or the filing parts we are converted into a powders, and we are using for the manufacturing of different types of polybutadiene powder or different types of iron or copper. Okay, then crushing process, have you seen crushing? Have you seen crushing? In crushing, what we did, we are taking the different types of stones or different sizes of stone inside the crusher, and their rolling process or by rolling or disc wheel process, we are converted that particular stone into a different types of particles. That means design, size of shape and particles. There are different types of screening machine or different types of sievers are fitted over there. According to requirement, the size of stone we can manage over there. Here also, we are sending the different types of inputs of metals or parts of the metals inside the hooper, and that hooper sends that particular metal to the rolling, and from the rolling we are converted that particular metal into a powder form according to requirement. Suppose if you want to size of powder in a microns, we can achieve that particular powder in the microns. Okay. Then the next process, which is used for the manufacturing of powder, which is milling process. The milling process also categorized under two parts. Which are the two parts? Which are the two different parts? The milling process, that is dry mill and wet mill process. Okay. And wet mill process. In dry mill process, we are just keeping the component inside one die or inside one container. The container may contain the hard balls, which is continuously rotating at a desired speed, and that particular hard balls are continuously striking on the metals. And as we are running for a desired time, the metal particles are started to break down into a small, small particles, and finally we can achieve the particles or powder. But in dry mill process, the shape of the powder is irregular because the friction in between that particular hard balls is more. That's why we further go for the wet milling process. The diagram, draw the diagram for the wet milling process. Here, one container is there, and in that container we are keeping the different types of hard balls. Hard metal balls, and in that particular hard balls we are kept inside one solution. The solution may be a distilled water solution may be a stearic acid, solution may be a different types of alcohols we can use for the weight cleaning process. Here what we did in dry milling process, what is the disadvantage? The particle size of that particular powder is irregular, or there may be chances of friction between or generation of heat due to the continuous bombardment of the metal particles or metal hard balls with each other. To avoid that problem, or to avoid the wear and tear between that particular hard metal particles, we are using for the, or we are going for the wet mill process. And by after striking or after completion, that particular metals or inputs of metal which are kept inside that container is converted into a metal powder. Okay, and here also we are getting the regular shape of the particles of the powder. Okay, then next process, which is shotting process. In shotting process, what we did, we are taking the molten metal, or we are pouring that particular molten metal on one vibrating screen. That particular vibrating screen is having different size of holes. Suppose I want to manufacture the powder in microns, the size of that particular vibrating screen is in micron. This is the name of process, which is shotting. In shotting process, what we did, we are taking the molten metal and we pour that particular molten metal on a vibrating screen. That particular vibrating screen is continuously vibrating, and which are having the different types of holes, that is sewer. Have you seen the sewer in a metal manufacturing lab? Okay, that means suppose we want to send a particular size 54 micron or 74 micron, we are implementing the sewer over there. Okay, here also we are fitting the vibrating screen, and on the vibrating screen we are sending the molten metal, and below that vibrating screen we are sending the cool the air. As the molten metal is spread on that particular vibrating screen, the particles of powders come down, and when the particles of particular powder is come in contact with the air, it will convert that molten metal into a metal powder. This is shotting process. What we did over there, we are molting or melting that particular metals, that is molten metal, we are sending on the vibrating screen, and below vibrating screen we are sending the cooled air, and that particular molten metal we are converted into a powder. The next process, which is graining process. In graining process, instead of the cooled air, we are sending that particular powder or the particles of molten metal inside a cooled bottle. That means in graining process, in sorting process, what we did, we are sending, we are pouring that particular molten metal on vibrating screen, and below vibrating screen there will be a cooled air. Instead of cooled air, we are sending that particular molten metal on vibrating screen, and the particles which are come down from the vibrating screen, we are dipped or sending inside the cooled water, and we are getting the fine particles of powders. Then the very important process from the mechanical process, which is atomization technique. In industries, for the manufacturing of different types of powders of iron, copper or aluminium, we are using the atomizing technique, as well as the advantage of that particular process is what? This process is used for the mass production of the manufacturing of the powders. In large quantities, suppose we want to manufacture that particular powder in large quantity, we are going for the atomization process. Let us see one video on the atomization process. In that video, we are pouring the molten metal. That molten metals we are sending inside one furnace, and along with that we are sending a cooled water. That particular cooled water convert that molten metal into a powder form, and then the manufactured powder is in the very large quantity or within less period of time. And then particular that powder we are sending for the further milling and mixing process. Okay, that is, we will repeat. I will repeat the video. Here we are sending a molten metal. That molten metal we are sending inside one furnace. The furnace is enclosed one, and to that we are sending a cooled water, and that particular cooled water convert that molten metal into a powder form. This is the atomization technique for the manufacturing of powders of iron, for the manufacturing of powders of copper, for the manufacturing of powders of aluminum. Okay, this is atomized, very widely used in the recently for the manufacturing of different powders in the industries, especially in the powder and powder metallurgy industries for the manufacturing of these powders. And then that particular powder we are sending for the mixing and grinding process. Okay, then next part, which is physical process. In physical process, which are the two different types? In physical process, which are the two different types are available? First one, which is in physical process, which is divided into two different types. First one, golden session, and second one, which is thermal decomposition. The another name for that thermal decomposition, what is the another name for the thermal decomposition? It is gaseous pyrolysis. Okay, the physical process also categorized under two parts, two types: condensation process and then the thermal decomposition process. In condensation process, what is meant by condensation? Have you seen petrol? As we kept the petrol in the environment, the within few minutes the petrol is escaped in the air. That is, the process or the powder petrol we called as a volatile. The property which is having to the petrol, which is volatile. That means, because of the volatilization, that petrol is comes into the air when it will open inside the environment. That means, the materials such as zinc, the materials such as molybdenum, the materials such as different types of chromiums, we are using for the, or we are manufacturing by using the condensation process. What we did in the condensation process? In condensation process, we are sending or melting that particular metal in a at a superheated level or at a superheated temperature, and then the vapors we are converting into the powder form by using the condenser. That's why we are called as a condensation technique. Then the next part of a physical process, which is thermal decomposition. In thermal decomposition, what we did, we have some types of carbonyls. Suppose I have iron pentacarbonyl, and that particular iron pentacarbonyl I have decomposed at a certain temperature of 150 to 200 degree Celsius. And whenever I am decomposing that particular iron pentacarbonyl, The powder of iron, that is iron, will separate out from that carbonyl group, and we are getting the powder of iron plus IOC, which is lacks in the. Okay, this is the thermal decomposition. What we did over there, the different types of carbonyls we are heating at a certain temperature, that is 150 to 200 degrees Celsius, and then we are break the bond between metal and the carbon by heating that particular material in a desired temperature, that is 150 to 200 degrees Celsius, and we are getting the powder of iron and the carbon monoxide is evolved in the air. Okay, then the next process of powder production is what? Next process of powder production, which is chemical process. The chemical process is divided in under three different categories. Which are the three different types of chemical process? First one is reduction. What is meant by reduction? The reduction is the process in which the metal powder is reduced or oxides or oxalates of a different metal powder is reduced by using the different types of reducing agent. Have you seen in a chemistry or in physics which are the different types of reducing agents we are using? Yes, can you tell? Which are the different types of reducing agents we are using for the conversion of that particular oxides of metal into a powder? What is that? Sorry. H2, that is hydrogen, then NH3, that is ammonia, then carbon, and finally these are the different types of reducing agents we are using over there. Finally the carbon. Okay. Here I will tell you one reaction. How to the particular metal oxides will get reduced by using the different types of reducing agent into a powder. I have taken one example, that is tungsten oxide is with me, and that particular tungsten oxide I want to reduce the, that is I want to separate the bond between tungsten and oxides. How I go for, how we will go further? The particular tungsten is reduced by using different types of reducing agent. Suppose I am taking the carbon as a reducing agent. Then the particular bond between tungsten and oxide will get break, and we have getting the powders of tungsten and the oxides are separated from that particular metals. Then I am using the same material, but I will change the reducing agent. Which are the different reducing agents available? Carbon, hydrogen, ammonia, and carbon monoxide. Okay, these are the different types of reducing agents we are using over there. Next, suppose same product I have taken over there, and I am reducing that particular tungsten oxide by using hydrogen as a reducing agent. Here also I have gained the tungsten powder plus oxides. You think that the material is same, the manufacturing powder is same, oxides are also same, but here difference is what? We are changing the reducing agent. If we are manufacturing that particular reducing or manufacturing of that particular tungsten from the carbon as a reducing agent, that particular powder is used for the manufacturing of carbide 13 tool. Because as we know that as the percentage of carbon increases, the strength and the hardness of that particular material is also increases. Okay, and whenever I am using that particular tungsten oxide with the hydrogen as reducing agent, that particular powder will get used for the manufacturing of different types of filament material. Okay, tungsten oxide, when first of all tungsten oxide is reacted with the carbon as a reducing agent, it will form a tungsten powder plus oxide. But that particular tungsten powder is used for the application of manufacturing of carbide cutting tool. And whenever I am using hydrogen as a reducing agent, that particular powder is used for the manufacturing of filament materials. That is general reaction for the different types of reducing agent which metal oxides then reacted with different types of reducing agents such as carbon, carbon monoxide, hydrogen and ammonia. That particular oxide may get oxide or bond between metal and oxide will get break, and we are getting the metal powder and oxides. Okay, then next time or next time of the chemical process is what? Intergranular corrosion.
Which is
Last process. Precipitation.
Different types of alloy powder also. So
suppose I want to manufacture an alloy, then the powders on parent metals, and in that parent metal we are adding the alloying elements. And to the mixing of that particular, or to make a homogeneous mixture of that particular metal powder and alloy powder, we are adding the different types of blenders such as alcohol, then stearic acid, then different types of, that is blender which is paraffin, wax, then glycerin, etc. We are using over there. And after sending that particular all solution in a container, suppose the container may be a, or mixer may be a Y pot type mixer, double pot type mixer, or oblique pot type mixer. These are the different types of mixer we are using over there. You will see the next video of a mixing of the particular metals powder with each other. Okay, we are sending that particular metal powder inside one container, that is by atomization process we are manufacturing that powder. Okay, and then we are putting into a double bond type mixture. Also, suppose parent metal we have put over there, then another, so I want to manufacture alloy, the alloying element I will put over there, and then finally to mix that particular powders in fair proportion or homogeneously, we are adding the lubricants. Okay, and then at a, for a certain period of time and at a desired speed, we are mixing that particular mixer or particular powder with each other, and we will get a homogeneous mixture of a powder by the mixing and blending process. Okay, here one advantage is what, in particular mixing and blending process we can mix a metal plus non-metal powder also. This is a big advantages of a powder metallurgy technique. But in casting process, can we go for it? No, because the melting point of one metal or melting point of another non-metal is different, and we want to reach that particular combination of that two melting points, and it is very difficult, or it is very tedious job to manufacture the metal plus non-metal powder. Okay, that's why we are going for the powder metallurgy technique, because as I told you, the melting point of tungsten is very high, and we cannot go for the by the casting process. Okay, that's why we are going for the powder metallurgy process. Another advantage is what? Here we see we are adding the metals powder, then non-metal powder or another alloying elements with a lubricant. The preparation or homogeneous mixing of that particular material is very high. That is, agglomeration is not possible in a powder metallurgy process. Agglomeration means what? Unka ikatta hona. Kis jagah ko ikatta hona. That means alloy ki powder aapko dale aur metal ki powder. Unka ek jagah satvan. In Marathi kya bolte hain usse satvan. Okay? Agglomeration we are avoiding over there by using the powder metallurgy technique. Okay? And then next process or next step of a powder metallurgy, which is what? That particular metal powder we are sending inside one die. Suppose I want to manufacture a gear. The shape of die is must like a gear. Also the shape of the punch must like a gear. Okay. Suppose I will tell you by the diagram. Is lower punch, and with the help of upper I will adding that particular metal powder inside the die. This is what enter, out. Okay, this is first process, compaction. The name of process is what? Filling of the metal powder. Okay, here we are taking one time. Suppose I want to manufacture a gear or I want to manufacture a round shape component. I am filling that particular mixed powder inside that cooper and then sending inside that by using cooper inside the die. The another next step is what? We are pressing that particular powder at a desired compacting pressure. And we are giving a shape to that particular loose powder by using the punch and die arrangement. Here, from upper side also we are applying the load, from the bottom side also we are applying the load, and we are getting one green powder. Okay. Then finally, after pressing, we want to eject that particular component. How we can go for it? We are ejecting that particular material by rising the lower punch at upper side. process. As we seen in casting, the particular casting, in casting we are melting the material, and that particular molten metal material we are sending in the, or we are pouring inside the pan, and then after we are getting the component. In sintering process, what we did, or what is the process? In that process, we are just reaching nearer to the melting points. We cannot melt the materials. I will show you by the animation how the sintering process is going to be run. Suppose this is green compact which is not having the sufficient strength before the sintering process. Okay, and whenever I am implementing that particular sintering, suppose I want to that three particles and which is having the porosity, and have heated that particular material. Here what we start, the diffusion of the bonding areas or contacting area will start, and the porosity of that particular material is going to be reduced. I will repeat once again. The compacted part is, which is not having the sufficient strength, that is green compact, we are sending for further the sintering technique. And in sintering technique, suppose I am taking the thick particles, the contact area will start to melt. That is, all the component is not melting over there. Only a contacting area is starting to melt, and then after, the inner porosity between these three particles started to reduce, and we can achieve the strength or sufficient strength to that particular material. That is high strength as compared to the compaction process. Okay. Then that particular sintering is divided under three different categories. First one, which is diffusion, second one which is densification, and third one which is recrystallization. First of all, I will plot the graph in between porosity. porosity and the density as well as hardness and strength. On y-axis, I have taken the porosity, and on x-axis, I have taken the sintering temperature. As the sintering temperature is increases in green compact, what is there? In green compact, the porosity is very high, and on the same hand, the density and strength and hardness is very low. As the sintering temperature increases, the porosity inside that particular particle is going to be reduced, and on the same hand, the density as well as hardness and strength of that particular component is going to be increases. Okay, and this we call as a phase sintering. What is happening in phase sintering? The porosity is going to be reduced as the temperature increases, and on the same hand, the hardness and strength of that particular particle is going to be increases. Okay. This is the very simple process, very simple. That means the diffusion of bond is started over there, and finally we can get the desired size and shape of the bond. What are the advantages and disadvantages of the powder metallurgy process? Here we can manufacture the different powders of refractory metals which are having high melting point, plus metal plus non-metal powder, combination of metal plus non-metal powder we can use over there. Also, we can control over the grain structure. That is, if we are adding the alloying elements inside that particular metal powder, the possibility of homogeneous mixture is high. Okay? And the limitation is what? Here, the strength to that particular powder, such as ductility or tensile strength to that particular component, is very dense. As in a powder metallurgy process, this is our limitations, and due to porosity or different types of problems, we cannot, that means the limitations is the particular powder, we cannot go for the highly compound. That is, the initial investment inside that particular powder metallurgy process is what? The die and punch arrangement, the manufacturing of die and punch arrangement. And we cannot go for the small scale production. If we go for the mass production, the powder metallurgy process is feasible. Okay? These are the different advantages and limitations. In this lecture, we have seen the different types of powder metallurgy processes, then powder manufacturing processes, steps in a powder metallurgy, which are the different steps, powder production, mixing, blending, compaction, sintering process. These are the different processes. And finally, we are going for that sintered component, we are going reaching for the testing process. It may be a destructive testing or non-destructive testing. Which are the destructive testing? Tensile testing, impact test, hardness test, fatigue test, grip test, and non-destructive testing to test the flaws inside that particular material. That is non-destructive, a microstructure observation or dye penetrant radiographer or ultrasonic testing. Okay? These are the different techniques.